Hello everyone, myself Mayanka, assistant professor in BIIT. Here I welcome you on behalf of our group APO. My topic is Shannon-Fanno algorithm. Why we are using Shannon-Fanno algorithm? Here's a possibility of information theory that we have to calculate the message signal with the required probabilities. So how we have to calculate? This basically depends upon two algorithms. First is Shannon-Fanno and next, second is Hoffman coding. Here we are describing the method or the steps to solve a Shannon-Fanno algorithm. We are using a message signal. Message signal should be denoted by M1, M2, M3 or a M6. Up to infinite number, we are calculating the message information. Corresponding, we have to arrange the probabilities in such a way that probability should be arranged in a decreasing way. That's where higher probability should be on a top and lower probability should be on a lower side. So firstly, we have to calculate our message signal and corresponding probabilities. Arrange these probabilities according to the higher probabilities. Here we have already arranged. So next step is the coding is we have to check whether the probabilities count according to the algorithm. So what we have to do, if there are n numbers of message signal, we have to calculate in such a way that the message signal should be partitioned in a way that n-1. Here we are discussing 6 numbers, so we have to at least divide, maximum numbers should be in a 5th column. So for divisation, we have to arrange a maximum probabilities in such a way that equiprobable probabilities should be arranged in a complete message signal. Here, the probabilities are 1 by 2, 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 16 and 1 by 32. We see that 1 by 2 is equal probability, which is not equiprobable to 1 by 8. So, we have to keep 1 by 2 in a separate portion. We have to arrange a 0 to the highest probability and 1 to the lowest probability. So what we have to do, if we consider that 1 by 2 is a separate portion, we have to arrange 0 to the maximum portion and 1 to the minimum portion. So what we have to do next is 0 for maximum and 1 for minimum. Next time we don't write anything to the code. Next, we consider that 1 by 8 and 1 by 8 is equiprobable probabilities. So, we arrange 1 for a minimum number because 0 for maximum and 1 for minimum. Here, 1 by 8 is a complete portion. So, next we have to consider 0, 0 for maximum and 1 for minimum. So, here again to the next comes to the 1 by 16. Here, 1 by 16 are the equiprobable probabilities. So, what we have to do, we have to change a 1 by 16 bit. Here, 1 comes to the last topic, that comes to the n numbers. Next, we shift to the next portion. Next portion should be, if here is 0, next should be 1. So, we write 1 in a lowest probability. 1 corresponds to a change numbers. If there are 4 numbers, we have to change in a bit. So, first is 0 and second is 1. So for 1, we write 01 and 0 for 00. Next is 1 is carry out in the same way and second column 1 is carry out from the previous way. So what we have to change the next probability? So next probability is a 1 by 32. 1 by 32 is the last probability which we have in this message signal. We change the value. We carry on the 1, next we have to change the 00. It would be a 00 or 01, depends upon our desired probabilities. So again, next in the bit, we have to calculate the number of bits. Number of bits are what we have written: 0, 100, 101, 1100. Carry on these bits to the required column. If 1 represents in a binary code 0, 3 represents the 3 codes that are represented here, 100, 101, we have to carry in a code. This is the complete technique which we use in Shannon-Fanno algorithm. How to calculate our values or our efficiency, that is the major problem we have to calculate. So we have to calculate the efficiency. What is the efficiency? It completely depends upon the values. Values are here HX, it is a entropy. Entropy stands for the probabilities and the number of matches. PK stands for probabilities and N is here is 6. So we have to vary a number from 1 to 6. PK probability calculate, we have to put the value of 1 by 2 and then the log values. We add these values to the last number 1/8, then log of 1/8. We add a complete series of message probabilities in a sequence, that is our entropy. In next thing, we have to calculate the length. What is the length of our message signal? We have to calculate in such a way that nk should be differ for different probabilities. Here nk is 1 for 1/2 is 1 and nk for 1/8 is 3. So nk represents a particular message signal in which binary code is written. So here is nk is 1, here is 3, here is 3, next is 4 and next is 5. Each and every time we have to write a nk. The ratio of entropy and a length is a efficiency, how much our system is efficient. Thank you for listening me and watching this video. Please log on to www.grookpo.com.